Hello, beta testers. Thank you, first of all, for joining me for Kyle's event. A guaranteed loot synthoid spawn shed some sad light on the drop rates. Way too many blues. But definitely granted some decent resources to people willing to jump back in or people still playing. I hope this little loot tunnel is something you all look back on fondly. Special thanks and crazy respect to those of you sending me bugs. Some of you are even pausing to show that it's the current build of the game, which breaks my heart because I only do that to counter people defending, but this was already fixed. Oh boy. When I read your comments and look at people's posts, I immerse myself in the sentiments of the community, and I edit some videos, I sing some songs, I make content that I hope reflects what players are feeling. I hope that this loot tunnel gave you more content than you may have been expecting from whatever mission chain and recolored skin event that they just dumped out. But to whomever decided to guarantee the spawn of this loot synthoid, well done. I can't help but assert that if this game were popular, this discovery might have been instantaneous. Think about if it were to happen in Destiny. Streamers play the mission, find the loot synthoid, people in the chat go, "Wow, when I played it, I saw it too." Other people go, "That's weird, I found it too." And before you know it, everybody knows what time it is, but the game's not popular, and its current state is part of the problem. Some people would rather the ship sink than acknowledge the holes, because that's mean, that's too critical. But not me. Showing you what happens is not me attempting to invalidate whatever work that you've put in between launch and now. It's me showing you what's currently wrong with the game. Somebody just asked me if it's easy to make content for this game, and I say, hell yeah it is, but only for me. Because as a real gamer, I could speak freely about bugs, glitches, lack of content, whatever, without fear of getting banned or blocked. Because what I see is a very popular tactic, a fear tactic used by cults. They tell you to fall in line and agree with what they agree with. Do not speak the forbidden terms or names, or you will be excommunicated. Talk to any ex-Jehovah's Witness if you want to know what I'm talking about. I can show you problems as immediately as the main menu of this game that, if changed, would simply make the game more money. People out here trying to convince you that Reddit is toxic. Reddit is one of the most neutered communities on the internet because of heavy moderation by volunteers with big hall monitor energy. And if niggas without a hall pass is toxic to y'all, I hope you find a new safe space internet that works out for you for all of 5 minutes before you come back to trying to ruin this one. You should have seen what people had to say about this game in places where they could speak freely 9 months ago when it mattered. But that's the community, and they're showing you what they want. And to put it in terms that Crystal Dynamics cares about, they are showing you how to make money off of them. As I have previously said, months ago now, this main menu is your action figure display case. Buying skins won't matter to potential whales if they can't even choose who appears on the screen because the devs didn't think of that. Emotes won't sell without a wheel because the devs didn't think of that. No endgame, no post 50 progression, no stats, no career page or leaderboard. Devs, have you played a game before in your life? I know everyone deserves a participation trophy, but these things might make players care. How can they care if you don't? A worse version of photo mode than other games have managed years before this one? It's not going to captivate players, especially with the off-brand Almost Avengers on display. I've made very concise videos about the additions that Crystal Dynamics should definitely consider by the time that the full MCU skins are dumped out in like 2 months with this every other week cycle I'm guessing you're going to employ. Listen, Crystal, Spider-Man pictures turned people into J. Jonah Jameson back in 2018 because I knew photographers who had nothing to do with gaming, but they saw these social media posts showcasing game captures of Spider-Man, and they're asking, "Oh man, you can do this in the game? Simply amazing." No pun intended. Shots of who? The web slinger himself. Not Almost Spider-Man, not Bargain Brand Spider-Man, not someone's specific and creative vision, but the familiar, recognizable, friendly, neighborhood Spider-Man, the lucrative powerhouse that Sony recognizes isn't broken, so they wouldn't try to fix him the way that you have broken things in your attempt to fix them. Fun, cool, attractive, sexy, but most importantly, profitable. Crystal, if your answer is preserving the integrity of unappealing designs that people don't like and have shown they don't like over a year ago, then in the competition for people's dollar, you will always be inferior. You guys ask me if I love the game buggy, and I really don't. I want it better for whoever wants to play. Never thought I'd be the guy caring about how a thing is represented, especially after watching everybody react to Star Wars, but here we are. With music, some people can hear when something is off in a song. Others cannot hear that. Some people can match a pitch or carry a tune. They can sing. Others cannot, even with practice. Some people have a natural musical inclination and can learn in days what it takes others months or longer. But this natural inclination applies to all forms of art. Some people can effortlessly achieve what others can't figure out in their lifetime. Some of us at a glance can tell you what does and doesn't work with half of these skins. What's crazy is that the assets exist in the game to really execute some dope skins, but they're not being combined properly. Does having this eye for what's appealing make me better than anybody? I never claimed that. Is there only one form of beauty? I never claimed that. But an eye for what is appealing objectively is kind of necessary in this industry. A pug is an ugly dog to a lot of people, but that doesn't hinder its appeal. Trying to tell people it's already fixed, that's trivial. It's coming soon. Other games don't have that either. I mean, this can't faze people when they have bugs to show you. As Bob Marley says, you can fool some people sometime, but you can't fool all the people all the time. I'm Jamaican, and if I can get one person to get up, stand up for their right to shake off all these people trying to fool them, I'll be glad. If an opinion is an attack to people and describing or showing problems is toxic, you don't need to engage or apologize for the lack of maturity with these people, and you sure as hell shouldn't allow yourself to be bullied into giving credit for the bare minimum. As an artist, I know musicians, vocalists, athletes, actors, entertainers that grew because of blunt, concise, and honest criticism that for some of them likely echoed in their minds and helped them polish their craft so they are whom people talk about. You may not think a quick Photoshop or even a thumbnail is a big deal, but translating a mental vision into a concept or a capture, that's art. You guys making mock-ups are artists. I've seen Fortnite take way less than what you're doing right now and creating skins and equipable tools for their game. The Harm Room is a holodeck that can turn Kamala Khan into Iron Man and spawn every type of AIM faction member, but it can't allow us to fight heroes or spawn different factions? That must have existed in the game's universe before AIM. I trip about its discount danger room because I expected, perhaps, a game where, like Fortnite, you could create things in a creative mode, which Fortnite allows for free, by the way. Like Halo, you could have a forge mode and create maps or scenarios to share with other people. My expectation is not that this would have been available at launch or even now, but that if you couldn't be the ones to be imaginative, that you could have dumped that on your players. The fact remains, if this game was what it should have been at launch, I wouldn't be here. I couldn't be here, because if the game functioned and was fun, there would certainly be much louder voices to bury all of the people currently talking about this. Thank you for your clips, thank you for speaking up, thank you for not just taking whatever you're given when it falls below the bare minimum. You're making the industry better one step at a time. Please send me more of what you come across. The Discord link is in the description. Love you. Like the video. Tell me what you expect from part 2 of the Red Room Takeover. And I'll see you in the next one.